All right, welcome to Lightning Talk number 5. This is Peter Verreit from KU Leuven. He's going to talk about Golang and iRod's web front end that he's been working on.
Yes, thank you. So at KU Leuven, we run a nice containerized setup of iRod behind the HA proxy with MySQL in the back. But that is not what I'm talking about today. So I will discuss how we needed to integrate authentication at our university and how we solved that. And from then on, we did other things among the same way. And it's in Golang, so the Go language and the Go client are the things we use for that. So there are two main goals we wanted to address. The first one is a custom user workflow. So we want to outsource user authentication to our university. Our university has single sign-on with multi-factor enabled. So we want to use that also for iRod and not have to provide own passwords or other things. So for that, we need a way to tell the users how to access iRod using the university's credentials. And we did that by creating a web portal written in Golang, where a user would authenticate against the single sign-on. Then the portal would create the user for this user that's logged in iRod, if it's not there yet. And for this, we use the iRod's API, and we speak to it using the Golang iRod clients. Once that's finished, we show to the user a generated password on the web page, which they can copy paste. There's a kind of a code snippet I'll show you that they can copy paste to a command line interface and paste, and then they'll log in against iRod. And then internally, iRod is using PAM password. So it's a generated password, which is checked against the custom PAM library, which is just making sure that the GVT token in use is a valid one. So that's one of the uses of this web frontend. But then we had a web frontend and we can do a little bit more. We also use the same web frontend as a reverse proxy for MetaLNX to hide authentication for MetaLNX. So because we don't want users to copy paste the password there if you can avoid it. And we made a little hack to auto-login to MetaLNX using this generated GVT token. So what we do is, whenever the browser wants to go to the login page of MetaLNX, in the back, we already do a post call to the login form with the generated password and return that response. And that works very well. So it's completely hidden from MetaLNX, the fact that we put it in front, and users don't notice that they do this login hack in the back. So that was also something we wanted to do, but we want to do even more. And we now have the Golang iRod client around. We have written an application in Golang. So we do a bit more. And one of the features is that group coordinators, project coordinators, could edit the members of their group, add new members, new colleagues, so that administration can be delegated to a certain group. And for this, we implemented some iAdmin operations in the Golang iRod client as well. So that's the first goal. I'll show it in the demo. There was a second goal as well. We created also custom admin scripts, like a script looping over all files and checking all replicas, whether they're healthy, but doing this in parallel. So there are tools in iRod, but it's kind of slow because it's serial. We did a parallel thing, also speaking to the iRod API. For this, we needed to implement iRepl, iTrim in the iRod client. So that was for the presentation. I'll quickly show how this web frontend looks like. So when the user enters the web page with a certain URL, which is actually the same URL that you have to use to connect to iRod itself via the iRod protocol, they have to log in. This is the university login, which is multi-factor enabled. So if I log in, I'll get a message on my cell phone to confirm. I ended back on the web frontend, and now you see here a couple of information. You see the hostname of iRoad, the port, the zone name in this case, the username, make it a bit bigger. And then you have this connection information, so users can just copy paste the snippets and they will write the iRoad environment file, and they will log in with a certain password, and it's using PAM. So DAVROT we also offer, but then you have to copy paste this generated password. It's basic art, we cannot do much about it. So this is the connection information. We even implemented the basic browser because we could do it with the Golang client. That you can just browse through the zones. I'm seeing everything because I'm admin, of course. You can browse and you can see files. This is probably empty. And there was even support for metadata for a folder. But okay, it's not showing now. As I said, there's also MetaLinux. So MetaLinux is hidden just behind the link. You saw me logging in earlier against the university portal. If I click on this link, I just end up in MetaLinux without having to log in. And even the logout links, I think, works if I do logout. I'm logged out in the portal. I will log in again. The single sign-on doesn't show, of course. And then there's this group portal where a group admin could join a group, an empty group. Yeah, administrator, probably it's not so. So I can create a new group. I can join the group, I can click on the group, I can add users, existing users to the group, and I can also remove them. So all these operations are supported by using the Go client and basically speaking natively to the iRoad admin interface. And there are even more options for administrators. You can also create users that will, administrators that will, groups that will. So these kind of stuff we try to integrate in our portal. So that was it.
That's great. Thank you. I hadn't seen any of that before. The single logout is interesting. That's always a very complicated problem. So sure. What exactly happened when you clicked logout?
So I don't care about the central login actually. So if I click logout here, I just do, so it's, actually I'm speaking to the university's portal by using OAuth. I'm just ending that session. But if I would, I could go to the centrally provided logout link if there is any. Could Got build it. Such a hack. Yeah.
So if you went back to the MetaLinks link right now, it would not take you in because you have logged out, is what you're saying.
Sure. Let me do that. So I'm just now going to MetaLinks directly. And I end up on the login page.
It takes you. Okay, got you. So you've wired in a bounce as well for the front door. Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Got it.
Yeah, it's because we have different types of authentication. So this is the left one is on for the university, the right one is for other universities on the same platform, and then you end up on another authentication platform and you can choose other universities.
Right.
Go to other IDP pages and even log in and then end up on the same page.
Makes sense. Thank you so much. Excellent.